Alright, how y'all doing tonight? I wasn't too enthusiastic. How are y'all doing tonight? Everybody doing okay? Y'all wake up out there. It's Thursday. The week's almost over. Get a little life. A couple years ago, I moved into a house, and when I was moving in, I didn't have the stereo hooked up. First thing I do when I move in a place is hook the stereo up so that when I'm unpacking and doing all the other shit you got to do, I got music going. But before the stereo is hooked up, I had a radio playing, and I was listening. It was a Sunday night, and the only thing I could really pick up was this gospel station. They were playing, it was like a call-in talk show for troubled teens. And I listened to the thing for 2 hours, and I don't think a single guy called in. It was nothing but girls calling in, and they were telling the preacher about what they'd been doing and how guilty they felt about it. He had preached to them a little bit, and then they'd have a commercial for people who send money. And he was trying to be the hip preacher and win them over. And he told this one girl that she had too much sex and too little Jesus. And I said, a gospel song. And so I wrote this song. Here's my gospel song.
Too much sex, too little Jesus. Stacy's been a troubled teen ever since she's 12. She felt the world close in on her. Listening to the radio on a Sunday night, she heard the preacher calling out to call upon his helpline. He sounded so nice, sounded so inviting. For a small donation, she could have the Lord Almighty. And she told him her story, and he told her his thoughts. He said, you better get yourself right in the eyes of sex, too little Jesus, too much sex, too little Jesus, too much sex, too little Jesus. Stop that dope smoking, stop that masturbation, take the Lord into your heart and stop that fornication. And we're building us an army, gonna knock out Satan. Visa or MasterCard or operators waiting. Too much sex, too little Jesus, too much sex. Jesus, too much sex, too little Jesus. Satan's made a slave of you, the Lord will set you free. You don't know God from it, and old enough to breathe. Sins of me and you are the reason he did bleed. And just a word from our sponsor, then another troubled day.
But anybody's got a bottle of whiskey hidden under a coat, slip me a shot. Not sure to sing better. I've been sick for about a week, and I'm getting over it now, but my throat's pretty ragged out, so y'all bear with me. This is kind of a love song, or actually an anti-love song. It's called Don't Be in Love Around Me.
Significant other while another night alone is coming down. I'm glad to see that the two of you got so much about each other that agrees. Don't be in love around me. Don't be in love around me. Don't be in love around me. Soulmates while I sit and contemplate alone. You'll be dropping acid, making love in the moonlight while I'm banging on this guitar. Getting stoned, man, I'm glad you're doing well, but please do it somewhere else. To something that I just can't bear to see. Called Heathens. It's brand new.
First hooked up, you looked me in the eye. You said, "Paul,
And I never have repented for the wrongs that they say I have done. I've done what I feel. Growing up mean and strong. When you tell me that it's getting just a little bit tight, ain't the first time I've been outgrown. Now I'm gonna push a little harder. She ain't ready till the rocks are thrown. I'll walk away. Forsaken by you or anybody else. And I never had a shortage of people trying to warn me but the dangers I pose to myself.
This thing's a songwriter showcase thing. I'm going to do a song by my favorite songwriter, I guess in the world, or damn close to it. It's a Tom T. Hall song. Tom T. Hall wrote this song about a friend of his whose wife was an alcoholic.
Pay no attention to Alice, she's drunk all the time. Hooked on that wine, bunches of it, has lost her mind. Pay no attention to Alice, you know she's a sod, saying she is not, but she loves it, and that's all she's got. So bake that apple pie from a memory. Lay them biscuits for recollection that she had. She cooked that chicken too long, but she don't know it. Ah, what the heck? You know it ain't that bad. Pay no attention to Alice. She's drunk all the time, hooked on that wine, bunches of it, she's lost her mind. Pay no attention to Alice, you know she's a sot, saying she is not, but she loves it, and it's all she's got. Talk about fun things like this. fish and I raise them hell. Drink another one down, Tom will have another. It's getting late. Sales station, he'll get her out. Alice put that ash out in the ashtray. Crazy woman.
This next song is set in McNairy County, Tennessee, back in the early 1970s, back when there was a sheriff named Buford Pusser there. And he was trying to clean McNairy County up and run off all them bootleggers that was bringing crime to his little town. And for his trouble, he got ambushed, and his wife got killed, and his house got blown up. So they made a movie about him called Walking Tall. And it came to the Martin Theater over there in Florence back around 1974. And it stayed for 9 months. And back then, there were only 3 theaters in town. And Walking Tall pretty much sold out one of them for about 9 months straight. So Gene Crump Chevrolet thought it'd be a good idea to have Buford Pusser come and appear live at his Chevy dealership. And the whole town practically shut down because thousands of people came to meet Buford Pusser. And for his troubles, he was given a brand new Corvette. And a couple weeks later, he ran into an embankment and died. So they made a sequel. And it was called Walking Tall Part 2. But they weren't able to get Joe Don Baker to play in that one. They had to settle for Bo Swenson, and he didn't do nearly as good a job. But I guess he did good enough because they made one more sequel somehow called Walking Tall Final Chapter. This song is kind of the other side of the story. This song is called The Boys from Alabama. They caught you smoking grass, and the judge threw the book, and I saw a little opportunism in your look. Take it from me, son, take it from a crew. I got friends on the inside and friends on the outside to sneak up beside you, so keep on the good side. See you standing there staring down at your shoes, thinking about your mom and dad and wondering what to do. Well, you best look inside yourself, cause we're all watching. We got friends in jail who can see you through. Boy, don't forget, no matter what you do, don't piss off the boys from Alabama. You know we won't let it slide. They might find your body in the Tennessee River, or they might not find it at all. And there ain't no place to run and hide, and your family ain't safe at all. So don't piss off the boys from Alabama. We're keeping an eye on you. Keeping an eye on you.
like a dog. You can take your fight or lose it all. The choice is up to you. I wouldn't piss off the boys from Alabama if I was.
The first half of this song's true, and the second half isn't. The song's called Old Timer's Disease. Guitar player from Atlanta, Georgia, named Gregory Dean Smalley, who is the founder of a festival they have every year at a place called the Star Bar in Atlanta called the Bubba Palooza Festival. And the band I play in has been honored enough to get to play it the last 4 or 5 years now. And hopefully we'll be playing it again this year in May, on Memorial Day weekend. But Greg died of AIDS a few years back. And the last year he was alive, he played over 100 shows because he decided if he was going to die, he wanted to die rocking, and just maybe the rock would keep him alive. And I was a sound guy at a club in Athens called the Hi-Hat for a few years, and I had the good fortune and honor of doing sound for Greg on about 8 of those shows. And he'd come in so sick he could barely walk, but he'd get up on stage and he'd put a bar stool behind him to lean back on when he wasn't singing. He would lean back on that bar stool, but when he was singing, he'd stand up straight. And you flip channels and you see MTV and you see some little boy complaining about his little pathetic rock star life, and I just think about Greg and what kept him alive. And this song is about rock and how it'll keep you alive if you don't forget about it. This song's called The Living Bubba. Bulldozers and dirt, bulldozers and dirt. What's your mama got hidden up her shirt? I like to play and I like to work, but most of all I like bulldozers and dirt. I met your mama when I was 19. You could have been any more than three. She got me stealing y'all's color TV. She called the cops and they arrested me. She was the wildest thing I'd ever seen. The way she pointed that shotgun at me, the police hauled my ass off to jail. Your mama signed the trailer to help make the bail. She picked me up and drove me home. Said, green, green grass under my feet, but all I can think about's the dirt underneath. Bulldozers and dirt, bulldozers and dirt. Behind the trailer, my dessert. Them red clay piles are heaven on earth. I get my rocks off bulldozers and dirt. Up on blocks, and I'm up to my ass in debt and hot, and I can't get my hound dog to quit eating my socks. I can't get you off my mind. And I lived with your mama for 11 years, through good times and bad times, fist fights and tears. But something comes over me when you come here. So won't you come over and sip on this beer? Bulldozers and dirt, bulldozers and dirt. Behind the trailer, my dessert. I don't mean no harm, I just like to flirt. But most of all, I like bulldozers and dirt. Bulldozers and dirt, bulldozers and dirt. Behind the trailer, my dessert. I don't mean no harm, I just like to flirt. But most of all, I like bulldozers and dirt. But most of all, I like bulldozers and dirt. thanks for coming, by the way, tonight. This is a great thing. Really having a good time. Thanks to Mickey and Jerry. Thanks to the one and only Dick Cooper. And, my band's working on our next record, which we're pretty close. I play in a band in Georgia called the Drive-By Truckers. It's kind of funny, I play in that band in Georgia and they're all from here. But it's 4 out of 5 of us came from this area. But I don't know if y'all remember Rob Malone or not, but he's a hot-ass picker. He's from Rogersville. He plays with me, and Mike Cooley plays with me, and old guy named Earl Hicks plays with me. And our drummer's from Greenville, South Carolina, named Brad. We've got a few records out. I've got one of them for sale with me here tonight. It's a live album. And I also got some T-shirts for sale. If anybody wants to give me your hard-earned, I'll take it. But do a couple songs before I leave the next record. We're doing a Southern rock opera. We're growing up in the 70s here in this area. And the rise and fall of arena rock and going to concerts at the Von Braun Civic Center and the mythology surrounding the great band Lynyrd Skynyrd. And a few other things all thrown in just for good measure. But it's coming out this summer and we're about to go finish it up this next week in Georgia. So the song's on it. This song is about raising hell in high school. It's called Let There Be Rock. Dropped acid blue oyster cult concert, 14 years old. And I thought them lasers were a spider chasing me. On my way home, got pulled over in Rogersville, Alabama, with a half ounce of weed in a case of Sterling Big Mouth. My buddy Gene was driving, he just barely turned 16. And I'd like to say I'm sorry, but we live to tell about it. We live to do a whole bunch more crazy, stupid shit. And I never saw Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I sure saw Molly Hatchet with 38 Special and the Johnny Van Zandt Band. When I was 17, I drank a fifth of vodka on an empty stomach and drove over to a friend's house. And I backed my car between his parents' Cadillacs without a scratch. And I crawled to the back door and slithered through the mail hole. And I sneaked up them stairs and peeped in the toilet. And I passed out and nearly drowned, but his sister Dee Dee pulled me out. And I never saw Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I sure saw Molly Hatchet. And the band that I was in played, the boys are back in town. Skynyrd was set to play in Huntsville, Alabama, spring of 77. I had a ticket, but it got canceled. But the show, it was rescheduled for the Street Survivors Tour. And the rest, as they say, is history. Well, I never saw Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I sure saw Ozzy Osbourne with Randy Rhoads in 82 right before that plane crash. And I never saw Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I sure saw AC/DC with Bon Scott singing Let There Be Rock Tour. With Bon Scott singing Let There Be Rock Tour. With Bon Scott singing Let There Be Rock. Southern you, and this song's called The Southern Thing.
Thank you.
Patterson Hood. Thank y'all so much for coming out.